接下来我就谈一下在移民中所面临的一些问题可能是什么。在座的都是从其他地方移民过来的，可能你自己也有很多感受。最多就是第一个就是语言障碍，因为你从……my
next slide is talk about immigrant issues. Many of you are new immigrants. You may face many different challenges. The first one that I think we talked about is the language barriers.
因为语言是人表达情感、表达思想的一个工具。如果你语言上有了障碍，很多东西就不能够去掉，那么这时候就很容易出现。Language
is a tool to express yourself. If you do not master the tool, a lot of time it's very difficult for you to express yourself.
第二个就是文化差异。你从中国移民来，或者是其他的华人社区移民到这边来，你所面对的人可能更多的是，就是要在另外一个国家完全不同的文化里去工作的话。
And the second one is cultural differences. Many of you may come from a country or places that have your own culture. When you first into this new community, you may face many challenges. You may find others may not understand your thoughts. Then you feel a little bit unhappy and being depressed.
看，就是竞争的压力。本身现在这个社会，在你生活的任何地方，竞争压力都比较大。而作为移民的话，你的竞争压力就更大。为什么呢？因为前面讲的语言障碍或者文化差异，你所得到的机会本身就少一些，那竞争压力必然也少。For
many newcomers, the pressure from competition is maybe even greater because of the language barrier and cultural differences. Your opportunities in this new communities may be even less. Then you may feel the pressure may be even greater than others.
最后一个就社会支持方面不足了。在移民前，你周围有很多亲戚朋友啊，可以给你很多支持。遇到问题的时候都能帮你。但是你到了一个新的环境中，你这些资源都少了很多。And
another one is lack of social support. Before you immigrants, you have a lot of friends, a lot of relatives that could help you. You could somebody that you could get suggestions from. But once you come to this new environment, you may find that you don't have as many friends as you used to have, and a lot of time you may not have the resources.
那么咱们中国的文化，今天因为主要是华人居多，中国的文化和心理健康方面有什么关系？第一个，你跟我的情感的表达，中国的文化的话是不太主张你讲出你的情感。
And other thing is that many of you are Chinese, and I'm going to discuss about Chinese culture and thoughts. In Chinese culture, emotional expression is very limited. Even in Chinese, we have a very limited words to express our feelings.
如果你注意一点，会发现中文里面表达情感的词语往往和内脏、身体有什么关系。
In the Chinese words, a lot of words that to express your emotion actually related to your organs.
天长瓜头。OK。第二个呢，就是民族特性。中国因为五千年的历史，养成了很，就是说这种民族特性可能和其他民族比起来呢，有很多不同的地方。你比如说，咱们经常说吃苦耐劳。
自强不息，因为在中国历史有太多的苦难，这个民族你要再苦难中生存下来，就必须有特殊的品质。Another one is national characteristics. Chinese has a 5,000 years of history. A lot of time our words, because we are facing many challenges previously, so a lot of our characteristics may effect on the words such as hardworking and never give up.
就是我最近也看过一篇文章，就是对那些早期的中国来的移民，到美国、加拿大移民，他们的吃苦耐劳真的是非常非常高，很能吃苦耐劳，很多在别人人看来不可能收起来，老一代的移民和这他们都收起来。
I recently read an article. It talked about how the old, earlier Chinese immigrants how they survived in this new environment. A lot of times we see that there's so many challenges. There's no way that they could survive. However, because of the hard working, they did survive.
比较遗憾的是，现在一些比较年轻的移民呢，这方面的性质要这特点呢要少一些。
However, the new generation doesn't seem to have been as hardworking as the older generation.
第三个就是社会价值观念。中国的文化很大程度上受到那个儒家、佛教以及道教的影响，很主张人和自然的和谐。
Another thing is social values. Chinese culture usually talked about Confucianism, Buddhism, and Taoism, and also talked about how to balance the nature and human being.
那么这三种流派对人有什么主张呢？我有一点比较类似，就是顺其自然。哎，有什么事情发生了，我可能抵抗不了，我的个人能力有限，那么我就顺着。最著名的那个历史上大禹治水的故事。啊，以前都是堵，其实有的矿里堵是堵不住的，那就干脆疏导，该怎么走怎么完了。
And one of the example will be go with the flow. If I can't, for when that happen, why don't I just go with the flow?
逆来顺受这个词其实是个贬义词啊，但是呢，在应对心理问题的时候，有的时候逆来顺受了，反而有利于你的心理健康。
Be able to accept the difficult situations usually is a negative word.But in this situation, it could be positive. It actually sometimes will help with your mental wellness.
最后一个就是家庭与社会的支持体系，可能你会感到奇怪，因为在中国和中国大陆的话，目前这种社会保健体系不是那么完整。但是中国文化里，家庭的概念是很强烈的，尤其在计划生育以前，每家有好多孩子，一个家族是生活在一起的。那时候人口流动也不像现在这么大，这种家庭的支持。其实是很多其他文化是难以比较，你就跟我们很不一样。像在美国的话，都是个体，然后有小家庭、小家庭。中国是大家庭。
Another aspect is a family and community support system. And previous in China, even we have before the one-child policy, the family usually live together. You live with your uncles, you know, sisters and brothers. Everybody lives in the big house.But in America, a lot of time, it divided into smaller families.
前面讲这四个中国文化的特点或者民族的特点呢，除了第一个以外，情感的表达比较低，啊，可能会容易产生心理问题。后面这三个其实对我们保持心理健康都是有帮助的。
The four different points that we just talked about, especially the last three, is very, very important for us to maintain our mental wellness.
那我接下来谈一下，那我们作为华人移民的话，会面临哪些问题呢？前面就是刚才讲的，普通任何移民都可能面临的问题，我就不再多说。这第一个就是文化休克，因为中国的文化和西方的文化有很大的差异，面临的文化休克可能比很多欧洲移民来讲要强烈。
We are going to talk about some challenges that new immigrants are facing. In general.Culture shock. A lot of time when we immigrated to this new society, we don't get used. We have a culture shock. We are not adapting this society as well as immigrants from Europe.
你比如说，在中国的文化中呢，比较主张啊，人要含蓄啊，要内敛，要谦虚。但是在西方文化中，可能他更主张你表现自己，比较张扬和外显一点。同样，两个人去谈一件事情的时候，你总是比较谦虚，那人家讲和你不一样，你面对竞争的时候可能就很不适应。
So in the Chinese culture, we talk about being humble, right? Oh, I can't do this. But in America, we talk about confidence, kind of show off. You show others what you could do. So when you're facing competition, a lot of time being humble has disadvantage.
个体整体这样，我们更在中国文化中更多的强调是整体的利益，或者我们这个群体怎么怎么样。但是在就是美国文化中或者西方文化中，可能更多我个人怎么样，我要能够表现出我自己的。
In Chinese culture, we focus on collectivism, talk about how the whole groups work well together. But in America, we are talking about individualism, how well that I can do.
第二就是情感进一步封闭，华人移民来到这里呢，本来。原来有很多朋友，来到新的地方了，朋友少啊，你能谈的机会就少了。本来我们情感表达就低，现在你情感就进一步被封闭起来，封起来。
Another one is emotional closure. in Chinese culture, we don't always express ourselves. When we migrated to America, we have even less friends, so it's a less channel to express ourselves.
上一张话里面我们讲到，就是在中国的话，你可能有一个非常好的家庭和社会秩序嘛，但是移民到另外一个国家，这个秩序可能就没有了。原来能够就是保护我们的，能够很少有性别问题的，现在就没有了，就很容易发生。Before
we migrate to America, we have a strong family and social support system. We have a people to that we could turn to. But when we get to this new country, we have a less friends. We have less people to talk to. And the protection, the layer of protection is thinner.
最后一个呢，就是对性别问题缺乏认识。虽然现在越来越多的人或者越来越多的